Well, children, in this session we will be discussing the properties of inverse trigonometric functions that is going to help us in evaluating or proving or solving the problems. See the first one. In case the function is of the form sine inverse sine x, then it can be denoted as x, where x will belong to the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. In the same manner, cos inverse cos x can be denoted by x, tan inverse tan x can be denoted by x. It is not that they are cancelling out with each other. Okay, so don't put the symbol of striking off, but tan inverse tan x can be used as x. In the same manner for the remaining three functions also, cosec inverse, sec inverse and cot inverse. If it is cosec inverse, cosec x, that can be written as x. Same with sec inverse and cot inverse. So for three of the functions I will be writing, but that holds for the remaining three as well. In the same manner, if it is sine of sine inverse x, see, this is sine of, this means this entire thing is denoting a certain angle. So sine of certain angle will be denoting a real number corresponding to it, and we know that the value of sine of certain angle always fluctuates between minus 1 to 1. So this x will be equal to, will be belonging to the closed interval minus 1 to 1. In the same way, cosine of cos inverse x will be x, tan of tan inverse x will be x, and as I told you, same will hold for the remaining three functions. Now onwards, the properties which I am writing, any one of them will, we will solve, that will support the remaining also. Now see the third set. How to convert sine inverse into cosec inverse. So cosec inverse x can be written as sine inverse 1 over x. In the same way, if it is cosec inverse 1 over x, it can be written as sine inverse x. Same holds for the other functions. Cos inverse 1 over x will be sec inverse x, and sec inverse 1 over x will be cos inverse x. Tan inverse 1 over x will be cot inverse x, and cot inverse 1 over x will be tan inverse x. So this is how you can convert sine inverse into cosec inverse, sec inverse into cos inverse, tan inverse into cot inverse as per the requirement. So proving one of them, see the third one. We need to show tan inverse 1 over x is equal to cot inverse x. Let us assume tan inverse 1 over x is equal to y. That means tan y can be written as 1 over x. Okay, and if I take reciprocal of both the sides, 1 over tan y will become x, but 1 over tan y can be written as cot y. So we get cot y is equal to x. Taking inverse of cot function on both the sides, we get cot inverse x is equal to y. So earlier y was tan inverse 1 over x, now it is reduced to cot inverse x. So from 1 and 2 you can see that tan inverse 1 over x can be written as cot inverse x. Then moving on to the fourth set, we all know sine minus theta is minus sine theta, tan minus theta is minus tan theta, cosec minus theta is also minus cosec theta. So you will find a similarity here. Sine inverse minus x can be written as minus sine inverse x, tan inverse minus x can be written as minus tan inverse x, cosec inverse minus x can be written as minus cosec inverse x. Again, proving one of these. If you see, I have not included cot inverse minus x over here. That we will see why it is not included here. Now see, look at this one. First one, if I assume sine inverse minus x as y, then sine y will become minus x. So sine y is minus x. Multiplying both the sides by minus 1, we get x is equal to minus sine y. And because we know minus sine y can be written as sine minus y, so x is now reduced to sine minus y. Now again, taking inverse of sine function on both the sides, so sine inverse x is equal to sine inverse x will be minus y, that is what we are getting. And on multiplying both the sides by minus 1, we get minus sine inverse x is equal to y. So you can see, initially we started with y as sine inverse minus x, and now we are getting y as minus sine inverse x. So therefore sine inverse minus x can be written as minus sine inverse x. Now the remaining three functions. we were always aware that cos minus theta is not minus cos theta. It is cos theta only. Same holds for sec minus theta also. But you will see here for cos inverse minus x, sec inverse minus x, even here cot inverse minus x is included. See, they are of the different form compared to the previous three we have discussed. We will see how it is obtained and why it is so. Cos inverse minus x can be written as pi minus cos inverse x. In the same way, sec inverse minus x will be pi minus sec inverse x, and cot inverse minus x will be pi minus cot inverse x. I have proved the third one here. Same goes for the previous two also. Suppose y is cot inverse minus x, that means we can write cot y is equal to minus x. Now, if I multiply both the sides by minus 1, we get minus cot y is equal to x. Now, how to reframe this equation? That is very important. Okay, we know that minus cot y can be written as cot minus y. But you will see, instead, I have written minus cot y as cot pi minus y. Now, there is a reason for writing it like this. Please see what kind of function we are dealing with. It is cot inverse minus x. So, this real number, okay, you just check the domain for cot inverse x. You will find for cot inverse x, the domain is a set of real numbers, but the value corresponding to it. So, cot inverse this real number will be a certain angle. So, you have to see in this which interval the value of this angle should lie. So, you need to recall the principal value branch for cot inverse x. For cot inverse x, the nature of y has to be an angle which is lying in the interval, open interval 0 to pi. So, no matter what real number it is, cot inverse of this real number corresponding to it, whichever angle you will get, that should lie in the principal value branch. So, we know that this angle has to be an angle in the open interval 0 to pi. So, if I write it as cot minus y, what will we get? We will get negative of that angle. Okay, that should not happen. So, you need to show that whatever angle you are writing, it belongs to the interval 0 to pi. So, instead of converting minus cot y into cot minus y, we can write it as cot pi minus y. So, pi minus an acute angle will obviously lie in the interval 0 to pi only, and x as it is. Then, taking cot inverse on both the sides, this comes out to be pi minus y, and on the right side we get cot inverse x. Then shifting the term suitably, pi minus cot inverse x and y on the other side, we get y is equal to pi minus cot inverse x. So initially y was cot inverse minus x, and now y is pi minus cot inverse x. So cot inverse minus x should be written as pi minus cot inverse x. If you recall the principal value branch for cos inverse x, it is also a closed interval 0 to pi. So, see how it is getting converted. For sec inverse minus x, it is again the closed interval 0 to pi excluding the angle pi by 2. So, you can find a similarity in these three of them.